Hi, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going over your second option in bringing column level security into Power BI. All right, this is a topic that is fascinating to me, really excited about this. This is something that large companies or organizations get really challenged with, but you in a small company, you know, if you're in a small company, you may have these same questions. So how can you protect a field inside of your model or a measure or a set of measures inside of your Power BI report? So you want to create a Power BI report, and some people have access to sales and some people have access to costs, but they're not the same. You want to have one report and both parties can access it. But you don't want the people who have access to cost information to be able to see, or the people who don't have access to cost can't see that cost information. So let's head on down to my desktop. I'm going to show you how to make this happen. Okay, so what you can do in order to make this happen is this is a couple things you have to do. Number one, you have to pivot your table. Then you have to put row level security on your columns. Okay, so you know, you may have your measures or inside your fact table, you've got a whole bunch of, you know, surrogate keys, right? Then you've got a whole bunch of measures, right? Lined up, right? The challenge is you don't want, you know, to give access to everything there. How do you do it, right? Well, what you do is you just simply pivot that information on its side. So you can then start to take advantage of row level security. I'm going to show you that right here inside this one. So if I go over to my tables, and I go over to my reseller sales, I can see that I've got all of my measures. I can't allow some people to see access to cost information. I want to protect that, right? So I can pivot my information. So instead of having all of my columns or all of my values on columns, I now have them on rows, right? And so I can kind of see this by this attribute column here. I can hone in and I can see, you know, the different measure types that exist inside my model. Now, if I was doing this for more than just a demo, I would go in and I would actually build out a dimension. I'd give this a surrogate key and make sure that inside my fact table, I only had integers, but this is just for for a demonstration, okay? So I build out this, I do this pivot. If we go into the transform data step, so if I go into my reseller sales, you can see that, you know, it all of these values are here as we'd expect, right? We went in and we changed some values, and then we use a function called unpivot, okay? Basically, that allowed me to keep all my surrogate keys as keys and then pivot so that I get all of my you know, attributes as, you know, certain attributes as values. So I put this in place. And then the next thing I did, once I had that in place, is I went into my roles and I created a new role called no cost. And I went down to my fact reseller sales and I basically put in some row level security on it. If someone is in this no cost space, the attributes that they're allowed to see is freight, order quantity, sales amount, and tax amount. All right, so this will limit whoever's coming in with the no cost role to be only able to see these measures. This works great. So I can go over and I can check out my reports. And now as an admin, I see everything, right? But if I go in under modeling and I say view as, and I say a user with the no cost role, I click okay. It's gonna show me that I now only have access to those measures that we said that the user has. All of the other measures are no longer available to that user. If Report Builder A has access to that measure and he shares it to Consumer B and Consumer B doesn't have access to that information, Consumer B is not gonna see this. So you can make this available for self-service, business intelligence, so people can build this stuff out. Not a problem, super great. Some challenges though with this, is this doesn't work for dimensions, right? You can't pivot dimensions, at least not in a star schema and not in a reasonable way for this to work. Your fact table will get larger. It'll get much longer. It's often not a problem as long as you have all integers inside of your fact table. Integers will mean that the compression and the hashing of your surrogate keys is very small. and it does not extend, it doesn't increase the size terribly. And this process will also make transactional math very difficult to do inside of this framework. When you pivot it, all of a sudden, that sense of a transaction is harder, much harder to capture inside of analysis services. You're going to have problems. You're most likely going to need to push that math back up the chain prior to the pivot and make that a new measure that comes through into your RLS. Awesome. Thank you very much. I hope you found that helpful. We just covered how you can add in column level security by pivoting your fact table, adding in RLS. Last time we covered how you can do column level security with dynamic query and backend encryption. Next time we're going to be going over how you can use object level security to provide column level security. And then next following after that, we're going to be going into the multiplier and how you can make that work. Hopefully you find this helpful. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below, share this to your coworkers, say, hey, this is some incredible stuff. We should think about implementing this. If you have questions, comments, let me know. Love to hear from you. There are pros and cons of each of these methods for how we can enable this stuff. So please, if you like one more than the other, let me know. Thank you guys so much. You guys have a great day. Peace.